Your vision.
Your vision. Pono ya gao.
This year.
Mwaha woke.
You are here.
Wena umo.
Because of the vision.
Kaleba kala pono.
That God gave you.
Pono e papa u feeling.
It must manifest
it
from today.
Ito tagelela ibona galoto wali kona.
But vision is in you.
Tano a pono ite chuo ba ili kona wena.
There are tasks around you.
Ona le mishumo kauswe.
What is a vision?
Pono ke.
Vision shows you where you are going.
Pono ibonja wena uruya kai.
Vision is you are able to see.
Ukona ubona.
Your future.
Bokamuso.
In the spirit before you reach it.
When
God gives you vision, he's telling you don't be surprised of what you are facing, which are the attacks because of the same vision. The attacks you are seeing, they are there to close your eyes from the vision you have been given. Write the vision on a clay. Not on a sand. On a clay. In other words, make it permanent. God wants your vision to be permanent. What he showed you to become. Write it on a clay. Whereby when somebody wants to crush it, it will be difficult for you to crush. If God say you will be a rich man, you will face poverty before you reach there. Let me prophesy someone who's listening to me. I want to tell you what God has spoken about your life. It's a vision that will come to pass and it won't delay. If you believe, shout
hallelujah.
Stop focusing what the oppressors is doing on you and concentrate on the vision that God gave you. You are supposed to be oppressed. You are supposed to be rejected. You are supposed to face tough
times.
But don't forget to worship him. Don't forget to praise him. Carry on with the vision even when it's impossible, because you can see where you are going. Do you have a vision? What you are facing is there for that vision. What takes you forward is the vision that you have been given. It's not the blessing you are having. It's not the suffering you are encountering. It's the vision that you have been given. There's a sea in front of you and there's an enemy behind you. Don't crumble because of the enemy. When you move forward, the vision will make
pono
a way for you. The vision is making a way for someone who's poor is about to be rich. Someone who's rejected is about to be celebrated. Someone who's not working is about to be a manager because of the vision. Move forward towards the vision. When you move forward, God will open a door for you. You know what happened to Paul? The same Paul. He said, there's a door, a great door of preaching the gospel is open for me, but there are many adversaries. Because where there's a vision, there are many adversaries. And this vision is like it's delaying, but it's serving for a purpose. There's a time appointed that you're about to be fulfilled because of what God has planted in you. Vision, establish your focus. Where there's focus, there's faith. When you have vision, this scripture will come to pass. In 1 Thessalonians 5, verse 18. You will give God thanks in everything, because it is the will of God
for you.
In poverty, you'll give thanks. When you don't have money, you will give thanks. So you will thank God because of where you're going. And you will understand that what is happening is a lesson to someone. Listen, if now you concentrate on what people are saying about you, you will forget where you are going there. The vision that God spoke with you. Vision. Help us to express express our faith. The reason why you are doubting is because you can't see clear where you are going. You are also rating what you are facing now as if it is something big. And this thing is beginning to take away your hope. It's beginning to take away your promise. When the vision is clear, you cannot be deceived. It's only a short-sighted man who doesn't have a vision. Always angry and displays anger. But a man of vision, even if he can be insulted, he will say, "Thank you, Lord. I'm going there. Thank you, Lord." A man of vision, he can see beyond the sickness he's encountering. A man of vision, he can see beyond what people are saying. If you have got a vision, you won't discuss shame. You won't discuss what people are talking against you. Because whatever they say, they are telling you have got a vision. If you don't have vision from God, you will take decisions by what you see. Most of the problem of our young people, they are on the natural. They are not in the spirit. So I was advising one of my visitors. I said, if you want to marry, don't marry because of materials. The person you are rejecting, he might be a millionaire tomorrow. Now you are looking at this person. He can't make it now. Many of you have rejected men of visions. From today, God will guide you towards your vision. And you will never fail in the name of Jesus. Many of us today, we are spiritually blind. We can't see where we are going. When money comes, it dictates to us what to do. Your vision.
Your vision.